Hi there, and welcome to the world of Alan Wake, a game that seems to have been gestating in Microsoft's gate basement for an eternity. It comes from the same studio that brought us Max Payne, something painfully obvious, boom, from the way the main character jumps. Look at it. It's like he's got three knees or something. I never like that jumping in Max Payne, it's bonkers. The story goes sort of like this. Alan Wake, and this is he, is a famous horror writer, much like Stephen King. The problem is he's got writer's block and insomnia, the second of which means he's often awake at night. Awake? Do you get it? Ah, please yourself. Wasn't a good joke anyway. He and his wife take a relaxing trip to a sleepy little town, which ends up with his wife getting kidnapped, as so often happens. Her kidnapper demands that Wake hands over a manuscript, but he doesn't even remember writing a manuscript, and then things get really odd. It seems that many townspeople have been taken over by some darkness thingy and want to kill Wake. He has to fight them with a really good torch to drive the darkness out of them, and a gun or two to make sure they stay dead. I'll tell you what, for a mild-mannered novelist, he's actually quite handy with the old automatic weapon. Here's an example. Here come the bad guys. Boom, there goes the darkness. Boom, and then you just shoot them. Alright, it may not be the most complex fighting system ever devised, but it's pretty effective and quite fun. Different enemies do take different amounts of light, those two were quite basic. So anyway, that's the basic gist of the story, and it is developed as you play, thanks to a very strong narrative and some pretty decent voiceover acting and very impressive cutscenes. It's all very odd, with some parts designed purely to make you jump, which is always fun. It's sort of like Max Payne meets Dead Space at a Twin Peaks convention masterminded by Stephen King. The game itself is fun, although the combat will at times have you swearing at the camera like it just raped your cat. As inanimate objects can also be possessed, you'll find yourself doing odd things like defeating a bulldozer with a torch, which is, well, that was an odd experience. Let's have a look at what the inanimate objects look like in combat. Drop in here, and there's an inanimate object trying to kill me. Boom, I'm just going to blast the darkness out of it. Oh, there's another one. And it's doing a better job. And there goes the darkness. There you go, an inanimate object, all dead. Never a bad thing. So if we go through here, I wonder what's going to happen now.
What the hell?
Strange things are definitely afoot. And Mr. Wake is right in the middle of it. As you can see, the scenery is very well painted. And bad things are going to happen to me in a minute, so I'll just wrap this up before I go and shoot them. Alan Wake, I would say, is a good game that's not without its faults. Some dodgy combat, poor driving and repetitive threats do bring the game down, but don't spoil it by any means, thanks mainly to the strong story and structure. Graphically, it is all fantastic, save for the fact that no one seems to be able to do people's mouths in cutscenes still, meaning the ventriloquist dummy effect is very evident as usual. So, a solid game that's fun to play, although maybe better as a rental, and that gets it 7 out of 10 from me.